What's up, Madden fans, guys? In today's video, we're doing another Inside the Mind gameplay, guys. It's where I take you in my mind as I play a game of Madden. And we're going with our MUT team again. We're rocking the Arizona Cardinals playbook on offense and on defense. We are rocking the New England Patriots playbook. If you guys like what you see in today's video, you can purchase these playbooks below. And we are. And see, this is exactly right here why I kick it short. Glitchy crap happens this season on the kickoffs. Tough way to start the game, for sure. Tough way to start the game. So, in a situation like this where you, and this is why we kick short, the idea is we don't want to give up any big plays, and that's kind of the theme of me this year. If you could sum me up in one thing, it's, in this year's game, I just feel like it's so important to not give up big plays, and ended up giving up a huge play to open the game. So, not off to the best start. Hopefully the offense can come out, get us started and going. But normally, guys, we'll be smoother. Sometimes I just kick it deep on accident, and I think that was actually, really that's what happened right there, is I just kicked it deep on accident. So, anyways, guys, come out. I'm rocking the gun snugs. Been running that for a while now. I was running it in the early year, but I was really only running a couple plays, and I've kind of expanded on it and really kind of gone primarily gun snugs, and it's been nice. So come out. What we see here, real quick, is he's rocking 3-3-5 wide nine. Don't know of any real pressure out of there, so we're gonna just run with our basic stuff. And that was a bad read to open up, but yeah, we're rocking this. You can see pinches his line here, does some adjustments. He's gonna bring that safety down. He ran cover three bus last time. And we got a one-on-one to Kelvin Benjamin. We're going to go up and try to make an aggressive catch. We do. And I like that. I don't like the, I like that route against that coverage. And that's really what I was getting at there. So he's been going with a lot of off coverage. So we're going to try and just run our zone of seams. And we had the check down drag and we just didn't check down. Not the best start for me by any means. Alright, so we're going to bring Sanders across. We add one on a zig. We'll check it down to Edelman. So, not a great start. Edelman got hurt. That's not a good thing. Okay. So we'll just go with our next man up mentality. Third and seven. Not too worried about picking up this third down. Just going to run the basic stuff and see what he does. There we hit that high pass lead. What I'm noticing this year is high pass leads are very difficult to guard. And it's really become... for me, it's really become something I do a lot, so, I really like the high pass lead this year. Plain and simple. There, Kelvin Benjamin, one-on-one. We got him over top. There's that high pass lead again. Offense is looking decent. Kind of a rough start, to be quite honest. We're normally a lot smoother as we run through these. So probably going to go cover two. He ends up going with that coverage. Oh, that was so stupid of me. So what I like to do in goal line is get into this single back bunch ace, as you guys know. Put Dre Archer in at back. And then I like to put all tight ends in over here to block. And we come out in the quick pitch and we... very quickly audible to this Ace Twins offset inside zone. What I like to do is just kind of try it at first, just to kind of see what he's going to give me. And here, tries to shoot the gap. We're able to bounce it outside with Archer. And we get in for six. Kind of a rocky drive. We still get in for six, so that's nice. But we're definitely not going to be able to just run zone a post against this guy. He seems like he has some skill. And here he's going to try to shoot that middle gap. When they try to shoot that middle gap like that, we're able to really easily... bounce that pitch outside for two-point conversion. So you better believe I'm going to be kicking it short for the rest of the game. I really didn't mean to kick it long the first play, on the first kick. So just like to make them earn everything they get. This is going to give them the ball about the 35. And normally I start off in the dime 1-4-6, as you guys know, if you guys have been watching the channel. If you guys like what you see today, be sure to hit that subscribe button. It really will help, in my opinion, it will not just help me out, but it will help you guys out as well, as we attempt to, we all attempt to get a little better and learn a little bit from each other. So, but I like this dime 1-4-6 this year as just kind of a starting ground. And a loca, and a course bomb. Four verticals, so typical online player. Four verts, right out of the bat, so that's interesting. Not much I'm too upset with, honestly. If I'm being honest with myself, I mean, called my base D, and it just didn't hold up, so we'll have to work around that. Offense is going to have to come out and do another thing, do another work for us. Defense is not looking too solid. A kickoff and a deep bomb, and two big plays is not characteristic at all at how I want to play the game. So sometimes I say I want to play conservative and I don't want to give up big plays, but I end up giving big plays, and hopefully we can snap out of it here as we get going here. So 14-8. The cool part about giving up big plays, though, for those of you that do, it's inevitable. It's going to happen. Sometimes you're just going to give up big plays. And when you give up big plays, the key is to... let's see here. Oh, I don't want him on a slant. I want him on a zig. There we go. Trying to hit... gosh dang it. So... that's a prime example of where I've been struggling, is in situations where you don't want to TCP pass, and in this season what I'm finding is you really want to pass it with a bullet pass, but when you TCP, what that means is use the left stick, kind of like trying to left stick it to the right to give it more outside of a leverage. It doesn't work. Doesn't work very good for you this year. So, in my opinion, my recommendation would be do not use the left analog stick unless you know, absolutely are in a situation where you know it's going to work. What you want to do is no pass lead, and the quarterback will normally put it where it needs to be. Yours truly sometimes still plays this game like it's Madden 13, and I try to total control pass lead it. And oftentimes, what you saw as the result is I have an overthrow. So definitely learn from my mistake there, and do not do that. Break yourself of that bad habit. And we can't hot route. See, there it is. There's that no pass lead, and you see it's much more smooth. It's much more accurate, in all reality. So that is nice. See if we can hit Edelman here. Get that nice back shoulder throw. I love that animation. And so offense is starting to kind of come along here. Running a lot of cover three with user. You'll see that a lot from guys that still think it's Madden 15. For cover three, guys, I'm just keeping it simple. I don't want to tailor my offense to just beat cover three. I want to be able to beat other things if he does so happen to run it. So while we're able to be okay against cover three, I still want to be able to beat, you know, cover two and cover six and all those things. So that's why we're kind of just running our basic stuff. You know, you're not really seeing me adjust. And there, no one was open. So he's ran cover three every play. So third and one here. And this is our core cover three. If we're going to try to beat cover three, this is really what we're going to do, is this play right here. And there's a touchdown. So nice throw by Romo. I got Romo. I think he's the offensive style guy. But, yeah. What we're doing, basically, guys, is we're just running our basic offense. He's running cover three every play. And we're just going to say, okay, if you're running cover three, cover three every play, then we're just going to, you know, work the ball methodically up the field on those corner routes. And that was a nice back juke, but we got a dive right there. So, unfortunately, I made a really nice play followed by a really bad one. I didn't back juke, and therefore I did not get in. Or I didn't back. I didn't dive, and therefore I didn't get in the end zone. Got a lot of hit power. Perfect's got like 96 hit power. I don't know why. I don't get very many hit sticks this year. But, all right, let's see if the defense can hold up a little bit here. Last time we just saw four verticals, and that was pretty much that. So here he looks to be going more conventional. This is something I'm actually used to seeing. iPro, probably fullback dive and halfback toss. There's the toss. Let's get out there, set that edge. Yeah, I've seen a lot of Todd Gurley. That's probably why. So three plays for him, three touchdowns. Oh, he fumbled the ball. Oh, that's funny. He covered it for a touchdown, of course. So three plays for him, three touchdowns. Not a great start to the game by any means. The defense is not looking too good. Basically nothing new either. Halfback toss. All plays are similar. So honestly, guys, that's on me. I mean, all of his scores are my fault. Completely. Not really the defense's fault. I probably played a little too aggressive. I blitzed every... I didn't blitz the on the cover two sneak one, but did go cover two, so I guess that's on me. But yeah, we got to score here just to stay in the game. So we go down and score here. We're going to try to score with no time on the clock. To me, that's a perfect drive if we can do that. So we'll see what we can do. Gosh dang it. It's like sometimes Romo, for me, either throws the ball like really, really well or really, really bad. And so far he's not throwing the ball too well today. And normally it's because of that there, we'll just take the check down. Oh no, his guy like warped into my guy, so that was interesting. Third and seven. In this situation, we're going to try and attack him vertically. Nice play by Edelman. Going to set us up here. We're going to go ahead and go for this. Fourth and three. I have a lot of confidence in this little zone of post play that I can get it against the cover three, so we're going to try and hit it. Here he's going to sprint out against it, so we'll just take this drag route and easily move the ball. Guys, it's really hard to stop my offense. And I don't say that in a cocky way. I really, truly say that just as a fact. The offense, in my opinion, is very effective if you make the right read. It's all about making the right read, and you know, that's really what we pride ourselves on is always making good reads, especially if we see the same defense. Like we're seeing the same defense over and over again, so we're able to really exploit him. A lot of cover three. So yeah, that's why we're doing what we're doing here. Try to hit him. I'm gonna hit Julian Edelman late. And of course he gets a hit stick fumble. That's so freaking frustrating. So big plays. He's had four big plays, and that's the difference in this game. Four big massive plays. And that is so freaking typical. Alright. So we're going to have to really lock up here. There's a pitch to the left. Man, who is that guy on that outside blocking? Gosh, they are freaking shaming us. Halfback pitch. All right, we're going to try to do this. This is the run D. You run it right now. There we are, finally. And Gurley... Jiminy Christmas. Play action. And dot. Wow. What a way to open the game, literally. He's ran like six plays. Three of them tosses, and then two streaks and a play, or that's it. Five plays on offense. And, gosh, that's so frustrating. Okay, so it's pretty important that we score here. It's pretty important that we go down and get at least. Really, we need a touchdown. I mean, a field goal really doesn't do us any good here. So we need a touchdown for sure. So cover three. There's Keenan Allen. So we got three TOs, so we're fine clockwise. Bring Keenan Allen across. Wow. I cannot believe. This is so frustrating. I've never seen someone run the cover three buzz every single rip. This is seriously frustrating as frick. There's Kelvin Benjamin making up for our deficiencies. Like I said, I mean, if he's going to stay in this cover three buzz, we can hit that post route all game long. I think the frustrating part for me is that it's just so weird of him to just stay in this. So it goes cover three buzz again, and again we're going to dot him. Kelvin Benjamin, easy aggressive catch. We'll call the TO there. This situation, we're going to want to go here. And really what we want to do is we want to bring it like this. So we're going to bring Sanders over like this. Spec catch. Ah, come on, Emmanuel. All right. Zona Z spot. So he's going man press. So we'll get the ball out quick there. And see, that's why you got to have multiple reads on the same play. Here in this situation, we're going to try to hit Julian Edelman and see what he can do for us. Ideally, we can get him and hit him out of bounds. Beautiful. So a dot there. See, now he's starting to go to more conventional stuff. We easily beat that cover three. And so he's having to go to different defenses that he's not as comfortable in. So I'm going to try to slant. And we just threw a pick. This quarter is just a series of him making big plays and us giving them right to him. Daggone it. What a terrible start to the game. In every way. So you guys are going to get to see me fight through some adversity for sure. Can we please pick that off? Can we please pick that off? It's like for me it's so hard to just play cover two man, but it's like why would you play anything else? Like honestly. There we are. And picked. All right, we're going to get ball at half. And we've got to stop making these mistakes. I mean, we just made a... My gosh, onside kick, too? What? Literally. Wow. It's like turning the game off now. Oh, my goodness. And see, it's just a series of mistakes. Is what you're seeing is a series of mistakes. I have literally let him control this game, and I'm just going to give him a free play, a free shot deep. And, of course, he's probably going to get it. Connects, and that's a pick, and it's going to get called back. And we are making a ton of mistakes, mental mistakes in this game. Oh, and we draft another one. There's Ilka. He's thrown five passes. He's connected on two for 200 yards. My gosh. Streak after streak after streak after streak, and yet yours truly is making the doom just a stupid mistake. Staying in cover three shell, not adjusting. This will be a good learning experience for me, guys. I mean, this is exactly what I'm talking about. You cannot allow your opponent to make big plays. You have got to keep them in. Everything's got to be in front of you at all times. That's why cover two man is so important this year. You have to play it. I mean, you literally have to at least commit to playing it. 50%, I mean, almost 50% of your game plan. I mean, if it truly warrants itself, cover two man is worth 50% of your game plan, in my opinion. There's Kelvin Benjamin right over the middle again. He's wide open every time. And see that one interception. And look at all these mistakes we're making. We have thrown the pick. We gave up the kick return. I mean, this should be 21-21. I mean, it really, really should be. And we have just blown it. Aggressive catch. That should have been a catch, in my opinion. Kelvin Benjamin's got to make that play for me. A lot of cover three busts, to say the least. I'm telling you guys, Keenan Allen is a monster. If you guys don't have him on your team, in my opinion, you may not be playing the game. Make that catch, get out of bounds, beautiful. So right now, offensively, I mean, we pretty much have got to score, and we've got to score quick. Nice catch by Sanders. I think he's going to get flagged for something. We're going to get an unnecessary roughness penalty, so that's a gift in itself. And we'll go zone a Z-spot and try to get in the end zone here. Bring Edelman across. Nice play by Floyd. We're going to go ahead and go zone of seams. I really like zone of seams as a red zone play. We are way too good for 14 points. Wow. I can't believe that just happened. He better fumble this ball. Dang it. I cannot believe that just happened. So Tony Romo underthrew the running back. And, oh my gosh. Literally, if one other thing could go wrong. So there's a little end around. Can we get a hit stick, please? End around again. Back juke. Hit stick. Give me a fumble. No fumble. He got a hit stick fumble. I didn't get hit. I mean, good lord. This is really annoying. All the crap they've given this guy. PA end around. We'll go ahead and take a TO there. We need a lot of stuff to happen for us to be able to win this game. I just cannot believe all of the freaking fluke that has popped up in this game. I'm going right here. He's going to stick. Okay. So we get no score. If I was him, I would have easily taken that field goal. That probably would have put the game out of reach. I mean, really, we still need 3 scores, and we need them quick. So, anyway. All right. We'll see if we can't fit this ball into Benjamin. I'm trying to get a big play here. So either Bush or Benjamin, or this quick underneath flat. We got Bush deep. So that's a big play we needed. His defense is really interesting because it's not anything special. It's just a 2 or 3 thing. I mean, it's just those 2 or 3 little mistakes, man. And easily take this and power it in. Man, I just cannot believe that this is even he's winning the game, let alone this is even a ball game. I mean, really shouldn't even be in the game. We're just making so many mistakes mentally. But really, for this guy, it's 2-man under. It really is. When he goes down to this little 2 running back set, he's gonna run the ball. So we're gonna go clamp double go. See how we do against his running attack. I haven't used this much, but for every time I've used it, it's been pretty effective. And of course, Gurley just shames me on that edge. We're gonna have to get into our base run D. I don't like using run D this year because I feel like it leaves you so freaking open. But I mean, we really kind of have to. Oh, no. He's going to get us burnt. Oh, we got so lucky. So lucky there. I just completely effed up on my assignment. 3rd-and-1 situation. Probably going to go halfback toss again. We should not have called our play. See, just little bitty mistakes. I mean, we called the kickoff return too quick. Yep, he goes 4. See, we weren't ready for this. And there's a read option. We've got to... That's got to be a fumble, man. That's got to be a fumble. So he's obviously going to go for this. Let's see if he goes quarterback sneak or what he does. Oh, he's going wildcat? So we're going to quarterback blitz. And a little jet sweep. And jeez. Freaking 3 yards, man. I don't know how. I don't know how you get 3 yards out of that play. So here we go again. Come on, Rhodes. Nice pick. Xavier Rhodes makes a huge play. We're still in this game, boys and girls. I don't know how, but we are still in this game. Wow, what a play. Alright, so we're going to open up with zone of seams and then go right into the Z spot. We need to score within a minute here. And he leaves Kelvin Benjamin wide open deep. Huge play. No huddle. And we're going right into the zone of Z spot here. So bring Kelvin Benjamin in motion. We're either looking at Keenan Allen or Emmanuel Sanders. He's going to give us this flat route. We're going to take it, get some yardage, and then get out of bounds. So it's going to stop the clock. Hop back into zone of post here. We're going to bring Bush in motion again. We're going to do that same motion with Bush. We're putting our streak here. See what he gives us. He goes cover 0. And we're going to lob that up. Benjamin, probably should have just taken the out route, honestly, looking back on that. That's probably a bad read. So bad read by me. Because he's off coverage here, it's going to give me an opportunity with McKinnon if I want to hit him. He goes zone. So we'll check that down. And we got a nice injury timeout. That was a huge... That's a break for us. Zone a post. And we're going to bring him in motion across. Send Benjamin up the seam. Kelvin. Oh! So he took a shot there with Benjamin just because... Nothing else really was anything I wanted to take underneath, and I get the incompletion, which is going to help me later on. But he's giving us another look for this zone of Z spot. And we'll see if we can hit him. So Floyd deep. Not there, unfortunately. Okay, so we're going to go zone of seams. We're going to create and zone a Z post, bringing Benjamin across. Kelvin. Ah, a catch tackle. That was a huge tackle. We're gonna actually make a little adjustment here, and we're going to flip the gun snugs, and we're going to have to get fresh players in. So, and we're going to go zone a post, flipped, and we need Malcolm Floyd to make a catch for us. Actually, we're going to have to go Floyd here. So he makes a big play, and he's tackled just short. No, he got it. So he got the first down for us. So that was huge. He's going to challenge. He's actually going to lose the challenge. And, man, this is a tight. We've got to score quick. The clock is ticking. And we have got to make something happen quick. So check down drag. Easy connection. No huddle. Same play. We just have to kind of run the same play. We've got to score before the 2-minute warning, really. Kelvin Benjamin makes a huge catch. So, right there, I knew I was going to get a one-on-one, and I knew I needed to score quick. I mean, there's pretty much nothing else to it. I knew I needed to make a play. I ended up going up and making a play. But we've got to get a stop, and then we're going to have a chance to go win the game here. So he's going to give us this quick toss. We're going to take it. Dree Archer's going to get to the outside, get in for 2 points, a big conversion. And the defense has the opportunity to kind of stand tall and give us one last shot to win the game. So good kickoff coverage. We got a 2-minute warning. So right here, the defense has got to stand tall. And so he goes draw. We'll call RTO. And when he comes out, one running back, three receivers like that, we've got to make that adjustment and get into this dime. Because the nickel, honestly, is just not going to handle his passing. So you go single back wide trips here. Little play there to the inside handoff. Called T.O. And this is he's probably gonna pass it here. I'd be shocked if he ran it, to be honest. But we're gonna send the heat. He's going at that 5 wide. And we got shamed. Well, that's unfortunate. I think he's going to end up winning this one. So in a big spot, the defense doesn't come up for us. He goes to that 5 wide. He's been in all game. Fullback dive. That'll probably be it. I mean, if he gets a first down here, our hope is looking. Look for the read option. Ran that before. Inside zone. Todd Gurley, man. So we may have a couple Hail Marys, but that's about to be about it. So really, a really good game, though. Something we can learn a lot from. So he gets a delay of game. Now that's a big penalty. A quick pitch to the outside. And that's going to be it. So, good game by this guy. The defense just did not play well. It's really a result of giving up big plays, and that's really why you cannot give up big plays. The opportunity for us, I mean, he gave up not really that many big plays, and we for whatever reason had a lot of trouble stopping him from the big play. So, I mean, that's really the difference in this game. So a good hard-fought battle. But anyways, guys, just finishing this one up for you. I hope you enjoyed the game. I thought it was a good game. I lost. I'm going to post it, though. I think there's a lot that can be learned from my loss. I think there's a lot that can be learned. So hopefully you guys will learn from my mistakes of this game and not make the same ones. But yeah, thanks for watching, guys. I hope you enjoyed it. If you have any questions about stuff that happened or anything that you want further explained, you can leave that in the comments below. And also, if you'd like to purchase, I know the defense didn't look too good, but I mean, it really is a good scheme. You can check that out in the description, as well as the offense performed fairly well. Those two